Now, the price for the license is less than $20,000, am I right?
That's right.
Now, why would I ever consider paying more than that?
Because I intend to squeeze you. I don't like your kind of people.
Senator, you can have my answer now if you like. My offer is this. Nothing.
Fallacy 6. Without the wall, it's impossible to build a system or create it all that we need.
The history proves exactly opposite of this claim. All commercial systems are based on data, conditional logic, recursional loops, functions and variable sign. The fundamental concepts created by all paradigms are different than those. These structures already exist much before the first oval language small talk.
You're nothing to me now. You're not a brother. You're not a friend. I don't want to know you or what you do. I don't want to see you at the hotels. I don't want you near my house. When you see our mother, I want to know a day in advance so I won't be there.
Fallacy number 7. If we have some hard problem for solving, we only need to look for a design part. This is not so easy. Goff was written for reference, not a Bible for programmers, including the famous book Design Patterns, Elements of Reusable Object-Oriented Software by Rolf Johnson, John Vlissitz, Richard Helm, and Eric Gamma, can only be used by reference and most important should be compared to technology available. Most patterns would be replaced by already known programming techniques when was not the time of book was written. Peter Norvig demonstrates that 16 out of 23 patterns in the Design Patterns book are simplified or eliminated in Lisp or Dylan. 16 of 23 patterns are either invisible or simpler due to first class types, abstract factor, flight weight factor method, state proxy chain of responsibility, first class functions, command strategy, template method and visitor, macros, interpreter and iterator. Method combination, mediator and observer. By methods eliminates builder. At last, modulus eliminates facade. One can argue that the popularity of design patterns means that programmers need to write code where in the other languages they could abstract over more things, use first-class types, etc. Related observations were made by Hahnemann and Kitzhaeus, who implemented several of the 23 design patterns using an aspect-oriented programming language, AspectJ, and showed that code-level dependencies were removed from the implementations of 17 of the 23 design patterns, and that aspect-oriented programming could simplify the implementations of design patterns. A quote from William Cook to Lisp Scheme People, the Goff book is a joke because the patterns there are simply covering for lack of programming and abstraction of power.
È un nesto pecciotto di Nuova York.
Acca, vicino a me, non c'è.
Fallo vedere più vicino, che vuoi? Io non ci vedo tanto buono di lontano.
Il padre si chiama Antonio Andolini e questo è pazzi.
Oh, il figlio di puttana!
Fallo seat. XML is good and must be used for configuring projects. XML wasn't created with the purpose of setting up software. Its purpose was to exchange data between different platforms and operational systems. The X is derived from the word exchange. An XML with the purpose of setting up is complex and must be validated against the XML schema, and this process can be very slow. You could argue, like Derek Danny Brown, that XML has been misappropriated and misapplied. I find it so interesting that XML has become so popular for such things as soap. XML was not designed with the soap scenarios in mind. other samples of popular scenarios which deviate XML's original goals are configuration files, quick and dirt database and RSS. I will call these data scenarios as opposed to the document scenarios for which XML was originally intended. And in fact, I think it's safe to say there is more usage of XML for data scenarios than for document scenarios today. One thing we're seeing in the Java world at the moment is a cacophony of configuration files, where every component has its own configuration files which are different to everyone else. If you use a dozen of these components, you can easily end up with a dozen configuration files to keep it sick.
There's a plane waiting for us to take us to Miami in an hour. They'll make a big thing about it. I know it was you, Fredo. You broke my heart. You broke my heart.
Fallacy number 9. We must do every single business rule in a rule. Database procedures is not acceptable. There are some batch procedures and complex database operations which can be very effective if using the database resource. Sometimes you can gain better performance and have good integration with your software just making a stored procedure call. It's not so bad. Advantages of using stored procedures. One place is easier to maintain the multiple. Databases are fast and optimized and can be scaled well. The same procedures can be called from multiple different frameworks and languages. The logic is decoupled from the implementation in particular applications. The work may be reduced for changing applications when the database stays the same. Remember, I'm not telling you put stored procedures everywhere. Use the common sense rule. Fallacy 10. There are mathematical proof that bases are always predict. All science computer is based on maths, but unfortunately for a wall, it's not 100% true. Second, Benjamin Peirce, the main concepts of a wall are dynamic dispatch, when a method is invoked on an object, encapsulation or mode methods, in which case the state is kept separate, subtype polymorphism, object inheritance or delegation, and upper recursion. Similar in his book of 2003, Concepts in Programming Languages, John C. Mitchell identifies four main features: dynamic dispatch abstraction, subtype polymorphism, and inheritance. Michael Lee Scott in Programming Language Pragmatics considers only encapsulation, inheritance, and dynamic dispatch. Surprisingly, we couldn't find any mathematical proof that bases object-oriented paradigm today in any of those exclusively related futures. We couldn't find any very deep mathematical theory who can sustain all of those incredible features. Functional programming, for example, is deeply based on lambda calculus and Turing. Procedural paradigm is strongly based on Turing machine for explaining how it works. Logic programming paradigm is also based on lambda calculus and several other theories related. There aren't any deep mathematical studies on object-oriented theories either. Most of class dependence and other related structures like that are based on the graph theory, but it's always cited by indirect form. The question is, if you can prove something by mathematical form, how can you argue that thing is really right?